Could an ice age happen again? Well, it's something that we're thinking about within the scientific community. And the reason for that is that the ocean circulation is changing as a result of climate change. So my whole life, I wanted to be a vet. And then my father took me out of school and I sailed from England to India and then to Cape Town. And I got off that ship 6 months later and I thought, this is really cool. I want to do something more with the oceans. South Africa is a very natural laboratory. The important thing about this region is that we have very warm, salty water that moves from the Indian Ocean into the Atlantic. And one of the areas of my research is to try and estimate how much of that water is pushing around the Cape of Good Hope. We've got a lot of moorings that extend westwards from Cape Town towards South America. They are measuring temperature and the salt content, so the salinity of the ocean environment, on a minute-by-minute basis. So what we're trying to gather from all this information is how the oceans are changing. We start putting pieces together in the puzzle as to if the ocean circulation is changing in its intensity, how that will affect not only the region around South Africa, but the long-term changes. And the way I can explain that is that all oceans are connected. So do I think that there'll be another ice age? Well, let's look at an example. If we look at the region in the Southern Ocean and we look at South Georgia, which lies at 57 degrees south, it's extremely hostile, it's covered in glaciers, it's permanently ice capped. The same region in the north, 57 degrees north, such as Sweden or Aberdeen, is very temperate. Same latitudes, very different climates. And the reason for that is the difference in ocean environment. We have the warm, salty Gulf Stream that moves northwards and carries with it the properties of the subtropical. And as a result, it's almost like a radiator that sits off Europe, keeping that region mild. In the Southern Hemisphere, we have the cold circumpolar current, which keeps that region very cool. Now, the thing with climate change is that it's affecting our ocean currents. And what we may see as a result of climate change is that currents like the Gulf Stream don't extend as far north as they are doing currently. And one of the reasons for that is this big ice melt association with Greenland. We're starting to see a lot of very fresh water moving into the North Atlantic that is obviously playing havoc with the ocean circulation. So essentially you're playing with the nozzle of a radiator. You're changing the amount of heat that is being brought into one region. So it's not something that we'll see in our lifetime, but if we look at sort of project 500 years or so into the future, one knock-on effect of climate change could be a cooling down of certainly the North Atlantic if the Gulf Stream does not extend as far north as it currently does.